I genuinely cannot believe that we've managed to identify everything. Right, where am I? Okay. So, we can leave the ship. And yeah, as I said, I can't believe that we actually managed to identify everything. Especially when I was editing it, I was like, damn, Kim, you missed some really big, stupid clues there. I feel like I could have probably been a bit sophisticated, especially with, like, identifying the seamen's and the topmen's. But, there were probably a lot more clues that I could have figured out. But, there we go. Let's go, then. Let's go. Take me home. I know what happened to everybody. But what's going to happen in the bargain chapter?
Sit down so you don't fall out.
Is it going to be, though, that the East India Company were behind this because they wanted those valuable shells? Maybe. See, what was it about the second mate? 1 week later. Okay. The Honourable East India Company. Insurance assessment for the good ship Obradin, victim of calamitous events at the sea. Ship damaged in squall Atlantic, sunk in storm Falmouth. Payout claimed £20,000. All cargo lost. Payout £5,000. Cargo Crown. All cargo lost. Payout 3,000. Oh, okay, so that's the company and that's the cargo. Okay. Oh, wow. So we're really going for everything. So, suicide, criminal findings, murdered 4 crew, estate forfeited to the crown. Hoskett. Attempted mutiny, estate fined. Edward Nichols. Fate shot. Criminal findings. Murder of 2 crewmates. Yeah, meant to Nichols. Asshole. Should have been fined a lot more. This guy. Who knows what happened? Fate unknown. Yeah, because some of them just disappear, don't they? Like, I don't know exactly what happened to the Swedish guy. Torn apart. Beast. Findings of merit. Exceptional performance of duties. Estate awarded this much money. And they're fined. He's fined. Clubbed to death by Brennan. So Charles Minor, estate unknown. He got torn apart. They're alive. Findings of demerit. Abandonment of crew and vessel. Estate awarded outstanding charges. So he can claim 50 quid. He can claim 50 quid. Extraordinary valour. Decapitated by the beast. Spiked. Blah, blah, blah. Do you know what? You can read this all in your own time, right? There's a lot here. Sefton, cook. Struck, tail, estate awarded, outstanding wages, £40. Like, he was a bit of a twat, though. He kind of brought that on himself. He poked the beast. The beast twatted him in the face. Extraordinary valor to the carpenter as well. Spiked. So the butcher was done good. The gunner... has done good. Gunner's mate, bad. Fined 50 quid for killing someone. So you've drowned, blah, 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 blah. Sprat crushed while having a poop. Gee whiz. Crushed by rigging, no claim for Abigail. What? No claim made for Nunzio. That sucks. Criminal findings, murder of crewmate. Oh, yeah, Emily. So she's been fined £35. So they've just got to find them. Where in Africa are they? Where are they? No one cares about poor Miss Lim. That's sad. They're going to find Beng, though, but nothing. No justice for Miss Lim. No justice for Miss Lim. What a load of bollocks. No justice for Hok Seng Lau, either. Wrongfully killed. Yeah. Philip Dahl, failure to perform duties. Yeah, so where has he gone? Fate unknown. So I reckon the bargain chapter. We'll see what happens to the third mate, what happens to Philip. Paul Moss, he can be helped. Blah, blah, blah. There's a lot of these to get through, so I am probably just going to jump through these. So if you're watching this on YouTube, feel free to pause, because there's a lot here. A lot here. Holy crap. At least the Chinese topman who got electrocuted gets claimed a claim. All the Chinese guys are looked after. Nothing for the Formosans, though. What a load of bollocks. Attempted mutiny. 23 pages. Honestly, though, looking at all this, I'm like, wow, we figured all of this out. Holy crap. It's funny seeing how much people get from this. Like, this guy drowned because of the beast, but this guy got sick, and he gets 15 quid, and he gets 5 quid. Oh, actually, he gets demerit because he abandoned the ship. Fine, okay. You win. You win. Okay, I guess he gets 25. He gets 25 quid for doing it. A preliminary draft of this assessment has been approved by the Royal Trade Guarantor. Total claim, £29,285. I, on the behalf of the Honourable Estate East India Company, certify these to be true, blah, 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 blip. There's my signature. Done. I love that I'm this investigator with a magical pocket watch. That is now mine. Is that my payment? Do I get the cursed notebook? Henry Evans in Morocco. Sassy. So what happens to the bargain chapter? 1 year later. Oh, I've got a cuppa. I've got a cup of tea. Oh, someone's knocking on my door.
Can you believe it? A package at this hour.
I can't believe it.
Oh, the thing smells just dreadful.
You smell dreadful.
You don't open it inside. I'll be turning in now.
Night.
Tea's in the kitchen if you need more.
Oh, I really want a cup of tea right now. Londres. That's me. Londres. Is it a book? Is it the book with the missing chapter? Consider me peaked. Chief Inspector, I write to you with the unfortunate news that Dr. Evans has passed away. He succumbed to his illness shortly after receiving your package. Illness, you say? He was very pleased with your correspondence and asked that his gratitude be expressed by returning the book to you, along with the means to complete it. As for the three of us that remain, the Oberdin is a distant memory and a dreadful chapter in our lives that we do not wish to forget. Do not write back! Regards, Jane Bird. I mean, okay. So Jane Bird, she's one of the two women that escaped. But yeah. So what is this? Oh, don't tell me it's the shell. Please don't. You haven't given me a shell, have you? Oh, it's a monkey's paw. Why have you given me a monkey's paw? Why have you done that? The tale belongs to you now. Please finish it. But you've coughed all over it and made it gross. Ow. Are we going back? Is this a thing that's really happening? Are we... Oh, okay. I guess we've got to figure out what happened to, like, Philippe and the third mate and these guys. So, yeah, I guess they paired up with Henry. Henry? Hold a minute. I've got a suspicion. Who had a monkey on the ship? It was the surgeon, wasn't it? Monkey. I just want to check something. Yeah, so the third mate is unknown. The Schweden is whole of Sweden, unknown. I just want to see, is there an Evans? Is there an Evans on board? Evans. He's the sodding surgeon, isn't he? The guy who instructed us was the surgeon. It was there all along. It was there all along, and I didn't. And he killed his stupid monkey! What a twat. I'm such a twat. Right, how did this monkey die then?
There you are. Collect your things.
Where's the key?
To that door. Gone.
Damn.
There's no time. We need to go.
Right. Here you go.
What are you up to?
Nothing good.
Okay, is that... Okay. That's... Oh, did you just shoot... What? Why have you shot the monkey? Why have you shot the monkey? What the hell? The third mate. So the third mate's been spiked. I'm presuming I'm in the lazarette right now. What happened to you? Oh, you've got no hand. Oh, you went into the mystical, magical portal. What the... My brain hurts. My brain hurts. Henry, why you do this to me? Okay. People in chat saying the monkey died so we may know the truth. Monkey claw! So. A friendly but not entirely pleasant monkey companion was sacrificed in the pursuit of knowledge. Aww. So you killed your little monkey. Collect your things so that, gone, Dan, there's no time. We need to go right. In you go. What you're up to. So he puts the monkey in and he shoots the monkey so that we can see what happened. Right, so let's see how you get spiked. I like the third mate.
A third shell.
The captain didn't toss them all.
Leave it. Help me lift this.
You free!
Give it the shell!
Do it!
Hoist it out. To the main deck. Throw it over. Lock the door when you leave.
Get the tail, boy.
The ship. Leoberton. See it home.
I mean, I guess it did kind of make it home, but it kind of didn't. So, they're trying to make good, basically. So the stewards and, which steward are you? First mate steward, yep. So the stewards are trying to make good, right? I feel like Philip was trying to fix things, but didn't very well. But he got spiked by a mermaid. That's sad. I liked him. He was a good guy. I'm just stood on the mermaid now. I wonder if they're going to cuss me. So I guess, well, I can identify you if I want. Who are you? So, Martin Parrot got spiked by a terrible beast. Sorry, Martin. Oh, hello. What? What? Is that one of the mermaids?
I'll kill every last one of you monsters. Withdraw the Kraken, or I will kill you all!
So this sounds like the captain to me. Yeah, so the captain killed the mermaid. So Philip's been up to something. I think he discovers that there's a third shell in here because they didn't realise that this chest had another shell inside it. So maybe this guy, because he was always like, "You're crazy." So I think he realised that there's a third shell here. And the captain probably isn't quite as clued up at this point. So yeah. Hmm. And the captain's trying to make a bargain, like, I'm going to poke you unless you get the Kraken to piss off. So he was trying to do his best. Because they were like, oh, where's the captain? He's come up from the hold. That's what they say later on. When escape. Yeah. When all of this happens, the captain comes up from the hold. And then that's when it all starts going to crap. Right, what's next? Are we going to see how... Oh, wait, there's another mermaid dead in here.
Call it off, damn you! This is your Kraken! You brought it here! Send it back!
Oh, Captain! So, I should probably point out, I wondered if this was open sea, and then I was like, no, that's a dumb idea. So, this is actually, like, little kind of wet lockers, as it were. So, they brought some of the mermaids down here, didn't they? To store. I thought it was going to be like that. They were just letting them go. But no. So Captain's on a killing rampage. But it didn't work. Right. Poor Captain. He tried. I guess that Easter egg I mentioned about how there's a special ending, or at least a trophy if you blame the captain for every single death. And I guess he kind of is responsible because, like, yeah, I don't think they were happy with the fact that he shot more mermaids. Right. Philip, what happened to you? I imagine you were trying to return the shell.
This? Quicksilver.
Okay. So that's what the magical chest had. Quicksilver. Oh dear. But I guess in fishing in and getting the quicksilver, he got out the shell, because there's a shell in his hand now. So you died the same way poor Beng did. Oh dear. Oh dear. So do we get to put a fate down? So Philip, burned? Yeah. All fates correct. Poor Philip, he was trying to do his best. And that's it. That's all the fates of the Obra Dinn. Never contact Jane Bird ever again. I just want to check something. The bargain. Yeah, so Philip opened the chest, found another shell. The captain came in to kill mermaids and tell them to call off the Kraken. Then Martin came in and discovered the third shell. And then I think they say, I guess they're throwing, they're trying to get the mermaids back out. Yeah, so the third mate's trying to get the mermaids back out and I guess get rid of the chest as well. Lock the door when you leave. And so it was really Martin who made the bargain that saved everyone. Meanwhile, there you are, collect your things. Where is the key? So that's them all organizing to leave. And then they lock the door to the lazarette completely. And then they go up to top deck to escape. Meanwhile, tensions are high between everyone else. And everyone's just attacking everyone because they're like, you're all responsible for this, you assholes. And then, yeah, so he dies. They all die. These four get away. So they manage to make it safe, I guess, as part of Martin's bargain. And then, yeah, Captain Mutiny. The end. The end. Well. What a story. Holy crap. Are these all other stories that I've put together as well? With my creepy pocket watch of dreams? Oh my god. I think that's the end. What an amazing game. Holy crap, I want more. I hope the developer is making more. I know that this is the Papers, Please developer. I hope he's gonna do, I want more. I want another one. That was such a good story. Oh my God. I loved that. That was amazing. I loved the way of like, the way it unfolded the story and things like that. So yeah, holy crap. Like I said, I do think I could have been a bit more sophisticated with some of my guesses towards the end there. Like, I definitely could have used more of the number tags and things like that. But hey, I did it. We did it. We did it, team. What an amazing game. I love that. 10 out of 10. Brilliant. More of the same, please. Oh my god. How's everyone doing in chat? What great potential for further stories. Yeah, because there's a whole bookcase, right? So we could have more. The Real Rang says many are saying they want this to be a new puzzle game subgenre. I want this. It's so smart, isn't it? Like, I love the way I've literally been thinking about this nonstop since we've been playing this and when I've been editing it as well. The Real Rang says Henry might have hid the chapter till after the inspection to protect the captain for being sued, especially since he didn't see the end chapter with the killings or the captain dying. But then I don't know, maybe. Would it have benefited them to see that, like, the captain was trying to make a bargain? I don't know. How satisfying was it as well when you managed to figure things out and you're like, oh, I got it. I nailed it. What a brilliant story. Also, fuck the second mate. That guy, what a twat. Greed. It was greed what done them. Second mate. Killing everybody so that he could get some treasure. Asshole. Favorite fate? I mean, Edward Spratt's got to be up there, pooping himself to death. I quite enjoyed, what did I enjoy? Kita Shimakaze says, apparently Lucas Pope intended Oberdin to be a smaller game, but it's snowballed during production. He says he wants to keep making smaller games in the future. Linia says, clap, you did a great job, Kim. I really love this game and it was great watching you put it together. How many of you were raging so hard that I got Charles Minor wrong? Because I felt like a dumbass when I realized I had that wrong. And when I realized that I misracialized someone. I got someone's race wrong. Ooh, awkward. Therese Alva says, sometimes it's hard to tell in grainy photographs. That's my excuse. Do you know what? I really loved it when it came together with the real life memory of the execution. And that's when, like, I think that's when the penny dropped for me. When when you saw like the stewards and the stewards all in one place wearing the same uniform. I know I could have probably obviously identified some of them sooner. Like the third steward holding the food in an earlier scene, which obviously I missed. But yeah, like just the fact that I could see all the stewards together and I was like, oh, stewards, 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 stewards. And then I think when we got the memory of all the hammocks and it was like, oh, hammocks, the hammocks have numbers. That again for me was like, big hints, big hints. So yeah, really fun game, really fun game. Holy crap.